So welcome to our today's lecture. Today we are going to discuss the engineering metrology. In engineering metrology we are going to study the unit number 5, linear and angular measurement. Myself Mr. Bipin Patil, a lecturer at Department of Mechanical Engineering in Chhatrapati Institute of Technology Polytechnic Hyderabad. So in earlier lecture we have seen the linear and angular measuring devices. Previous lecture we have discussed about bevel protractor, as well as we have discussed universal protractor, then vernier bevel protractor. So in this lecture we are going to discuss about the sign bars and sign centers. So let us see the today's lecture content. In last lecture we were going to discuss the sign bar. Because of their lengthy procedure we couldn't describe that sign bar. So in this lecture in detail we are going to discuss the sign bar. Let us see what is mean by sign bar. So this is the today's lecture content, sign bar and sign centers. So this is the one of the device which is used to measure the angle of component, angle of work table. This is the sign center which is used to measure the taper angle of taper gauges. So let us see what is mean by sign bar. So here the diagram showing the construction detail of a sign bar. So sign bar is made up of a hardened steel beam having flat upper surface. So this surface is made by steel and which is hardened. The bar is mounted on a two cylindrical rollers. So these are the two cylindrical rollers, so roll number 1, roller number 2, you can see over here. These rollers are located in cylindrical grooves specially provided for the purpose. So these two rollers mounted in parallel axis with each other. So you can see the axis of two rollers are parallel to each other. They are also parallel to the upper flat surface. So this axis of a flat surface and the center of these two roller is parallel, and these are an equally distance placed. So unlike the bevel protractor, sign bar make indirect measurement. Why we are calling it indirect? Because this formula which is shown here gives you the angle theta which is made by the component. So for this, so the theta can be calculated by calculating the h or forming the h, and the small l is nothing but the length between two rollers or the central distance between the two rollers. So by calculating the inverse angle of sine, we will get the sine theta, or directly we can get the theta angle, and that theta is nothing but the angle made by that component. So this is looking quite confusing over here. So making this quite easy, we will going to discuss how exactly the component is placed and how exactly the combination or the formation of a slip gauge is made. So the high degree of accuracy, precision available for length measurement, and here you can see the slip gauge box, or the blocks are used to utilize the measurement of angle. This relationship shown here and the angle of this particular component can be made by relation which is operates on the principle that is known as trigonometric relationship. You can see over here the sides between the angle is right angle. So this is the perpendicular distance, this is your base, and this is the hypotenuse. So the triangle is made by this particular arrangement. We can calculate by using the trigonometrical relation. Sine theta is equal to h by l. So let us see how exactly the arrangement of a sine bar is done. So here this is the constructional details. These are the relief holes which are given to handle एंड विच आर ऑल्सो गिवन वाइल द मैन्युफैक्चरिंग प्रोसेस वाइल मेकिंग द हार्डनिंग प्रोसेस दे शुड नॉट इंड्यूस थर्मल स्ट्रेसेस दैट्स वाई द रिलीफ होल्स आर प्रोवाइडेड दिस वन इज एंड फेस दिस वन इज अपर फेस विच इज हाईली फिनिश्ड सरफेस एंड लैफ्ट सरफेस देन दीज आर द साइड फेसेस यू कैन सी द सेटिंग रोलर्स गिवन ओवर हियर एंड द लेंथ इज स्मॉल एल और यू कैन से इट एज ए कैपिटल एल दिस इज द लोअर सरफेस द एग्जैक्ट साइन बार इज गिवन हियर सो दिस इज हैविंग 100 mm साइन बार सो दिस डिस्टेंस इज नथिंग बट द सेंट्रल डिस्टेंस बिटवीन टू रोलर एज पर द रोलर डिस्टेंस द स्पेसिफिकेशन ऑफ साइन बार इज डन सो हियर यू कैन सी दिस इज द 100 mm साइन बार विच इज गिवन टू मेजर द स्पेसिफाइड एंगल So likewise, you can see here how exactly the angle is measured using the sine bar. So first of all, you have to give the datum reference surface or you have to place this total arrangement on surface plate. I'm going to draw here the surface plate. On that surface plate, you must have to keep the slip gauges or the combination of slip gauges. First of all, you have to calculate the angle of given component using bevel protractor. This is the first step. So first of all, you have to carry out the tentative measurement using the bevel protractor. Then after, you will get the theta, and after that theta, you are going to calculate the h, but h is unknown. Then the small l is given. So as we have seen previously, small l is nothing but the standard distance between two rollers. So as per your sine bar, what is the center distance between the two rollers is your standard size of that particular sine bar, and 100 mm is a standard distance of that particular sine bar. So we have small l, only we have to calculate the theta. So already we have got the theta using bevel protractor, but we have to calculate in degree, in minute, as well as in second. So to get this accuracy, we must have to use sine bar. So let us see the second step, what exactly we have to calculate. So here, as I said earlier, we placed the slip gauges. We will get the edge by calculating sine theta. Theta we got as per first step. In first step we have done the theta is 27. Say it is a 27. We have used bevel protractor. And then the L is, how much it is? The L is 100. So sine 27 is equal to h upon l. So taking this l and multiplying this l to the sine, then we will get 100 sine 27 into 100, and finally we will get the small h. So this small h is nothing but the height or the distance made by the slip gauge. So suppose if the h is 12.123, So likewise, we have to mm. The height is in mm. So likewise, we have to made the combination of slip gauge like 10 mm, then 2 mm, and the remaining slip gauge we have to adjust, and as per the trigonometric relation, we have the hypotenuse that is small or capital L, and the small h, this is given here or we have calculated earlier, and this one is theta. As per the formulae, we can calculate the theta, that is sine inverse of theta is equal to h upon L. So this is equal to theta. So this is the procedure. Let us see. Then after the placing sine bar on a slip gauge, we made the height. Then in third step, we have to place the component, and the slant side of a component rest on sine bar, and after that make the arrangement of dial gauge such like that the deviation of a dial indicator should be zero over the surface. So first of all, give the points here, 3 to 5 points here, 3 to 4, as per your length you can divide the points over your length, and after that take the readings of a dial gauge. It should not give the deviation within limit, so you have to check first point, second point, and then after the third position, you can see over here, and in this position you should get the deviation of a surface zero. So it is simply like that, this plane should be parallel to the datum surface, and this datum surface should be parallel to the surface of a component which is made adjust by using slip gauges. So this is nothing but the arrangement of a sine bar, and after that confirming the zero deviation, you have to calculate the theta using the formulae which we have already seen. So that formula is nothing but sine theta is equal to h upon L. Here we are going to calculate the theta. In theta, as earlier we have seen, sine inverse of h upon L is equal to theta. So theta can be calculated. In practical session, we are going to study in detail about the measurement and the procedure of a angle measurement by using sine bar. So you can see over here. So this is a small measurement of a small component by using sine bar, and the second procedure, that is the use of a sine bar for the large component. As you can see, the small component is rest on sine bar, but in this arrangement you can see the sine bar is rest on component. So I height over the roller can be measured by the vernier height gauge using a dial test gauge mounted on an anvil. You can see here, this one is a vernier height gauge and this one is a dial test gauge or dial test indicator. The height gauge ensures the constant measuring pressure, and this one is reading number 1 and this one is reading number 2. This is achieved by adjusting the height gauge until the dial gauge shows the same zero reading each time. So here you can see how exactly
the readings are taken. This one is a reading number one, reading number two. These two readings are different because the theta angle made is showing the variation, and it is made the inclination to the datum surface. You can see over here. Because of that, the height variations in reading number 2 and reading number 1 is large. So, taking the difference between these two readings, and we will get the height difference, and we can calculate the theta angle. You can see the formula here. Sine theta is equal to R1, that is reading number 1. That is nothing but the reading in dial indicator number 1 and reading in dial indicator number 2, or you can say when the dial indicator is in zero, matching with zero line, then finally you can carry out the reading of vernier height gauge, and that vernier height gauge reading is given in capital R1 and capital R2 designation. So after that, the L is the standard size of a standard distance of a roller. So sin theta is equal to R1 minus R2. So finally you will get the theta by taking the inverse of sine, that R1 minus R2, sine inverse of R1 minus R2 upon L. So you will get the angle in degree, minute and second. So this is the procedure how to use the sine bar for a large component. So following are the advantages of sine bar. It is precise and accurate angle measuring device, because you can get up to second, degree and minute reading. So you will get the accurate reading. Then it is simple in design and construction. It is having the principle of trigonometry, works on a principle of trigonometry, so that it is, its construction and other design parameters are too simple, then it is easily available. So it is having quite distinct disadvantages. So let us see. It is a fairly reliable at angle less than 15 degree, but become increasingly inaccurate as the angle increases. It is impractical to use sine bar for a angle above 45 degree. It is a major disadvantage of a sine bar. The second disadvantage, it is difficult to handle and position the slip gauges because of its heavy weight. You can't make it steady while taking the readings because of the left surface contact. Then the third disadvantage, the sine bar is physically clumsy to hold and in position. The application is limited for a fixed center distance between two rollers. And the last one major disadvantage is slight error of a sine bar causing larger angular errors. So if you have the small variation in h, that will impact on your final theta. So the theta is a function of a h and l, so that if the h, you will induce error in h, then finally you will get the angular errors. So these are the disadvantages of sine bar. So let us see what is mean by sine center and why sine centers are used to carry out the angle measurement of taper gauges. So sine center is basically sine bar with block holding centers which can be adjusted and rigidly clamped in any position, used for the testing of conical work centered at each other, as shown in figure. You can see over here. This is a simple sine bar, but the additional arrangement which is provided with the centers and blocks, you can see, to hold the component, you can see over here, these are the centers, and this is the real-time image of a sine center. Extremely useful, since the alignment accuracy of a centers ensure that the correct line measurement is made along with the workpiece. Then the centers can be adjusted depending on the length of conical workpiece to be held between the centers. So likewise, you can see this is a taper gauge which is provided over here, and this is made parallel to the datum surface. And likewise, you can take the distance between two rollers, the height of slip gauge, and as per the sign bar you can calculate the angle of a theta using this arrangement also. So this arrangement is particularly done in precision calibration labs, where the taper gauge is calibrated and the angle of taper gauge is measured. So you can see over here, these are the sign centers. So you can see this is a dial indicator which is provided to catch out the deviation between or across the length of a taper gauge. You must have to keep the deviation within limit while making the true and probe motion of a dial indicator, and these all readings should be carried out on a surface plate so that you will get the accurate reading. So this is the sliding block, and this is the fixed firm center. As per your length of a component, you can vary the central distance between two centers and you can take the readings. Here you can see the dial indicator which is provided for inspect the variation between length of a component. So this is all about sign bar and sign center. If you have any queries, comment down below. Thank you. Thank you very much.